Whoa, what the? Dude. Feel what? Different.
What do you mean different?
Like, I feel stronger.
Wanna arm wrestle?
Yeah. Okay. Oh my god! Dude, where'd you go?
I fell off the boat.
Whoops. Okay. Well, maybe we should just start the mod spotlight now.
That's probably a good idea.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay guys, welcome back to another Mod Spotlight. Today we're showing off FPS, which stands for, FSP, which stands for Flaxbeard Steam Powered. And yeah. My brother, he studied up on this mod basically while I built this airship.
Yeah.
So he's going to be teaching me most of this, which is nice because as I'm learning, you guys learn how to use it too. So hold up just a second, let me check something. Huh, that's weird. Okay. Anyways, so where do we start?
Okay, so first I'm going to start off saying the two ores in this game are copper and zinc. Now, these are just normal, like, iron. You'll find them in iron levels. These are the ingots. I can never say that. These are the ingots. That's basically the ores. And then the first craft thing you want to make is an Steam Innovations book, and to do that you need two zinc ores in a book.
So I'll just take that.
Take the book.
So this is actually a shapeless recipe, I believe, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can craft it any way you want.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to open it and read that off and kind of...
Okay, so...
when you first open it... Whoa. It's not showing it the correct way. There we go. This is what it looks like at first.
Okay.
So, Esteemed Innovation, a brief guide to steam power by, well, I guess I wrote it, but it says your name for anything, which is pretty cool.
And it says...
So, it shows you the index, and you can click on these, so, like, if I click there, or if I click here, it will give you a brief description and how to use it. Whoops.
Yeah.
Just scroll through it, and then here's weapons, metal casting, gadgets, steam power, more steam power, exosuit, and
more
other exosuit stuff.
Yeah.
So that's the basic gist of it.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to start this off with the most basic, like,
setup.
Setup you can get. So these are all the things. A boiler, pipe.
Wait, put them back?
Oh. Ugh.
So you make a pipe, just by some brass ingots, and you make a boiler by brass ingots surrounding a furnace. We'll get to these brass plates in a little bit. Oh, and to make brass, it takes copper, I should have showed this, and zinc.
No, in the crucible.
You put it in the...
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
We'll get to that later.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so...
Sorry.
And you got coal.
And coal. And the pipe wrench.
Pipe wrench, yeah.
Brass and iron. Simple.
Yeah. You know how to make coal, right?
Well, you don't have any coal more. But anyways.
Yeah.
So he's just gonna build this little example for us. Seems like he knows what he's doing and I don't.
Yeah. So first you need a boiler. And then I'm gonna just make a simple setup. And see how this block isn't connected to that?
What is this?
This is a pipe.
Okay.
Hold on.
I got it.
Okay. So when you first start off you have to place it on top, which is kind of
well, steam rises, that's why.
That's true. You can, like...
Doesn't matter. Continue.
Alright, yeah. Anyways. So, it goes from the top. So, what you want to do is put water and coal inside of it, and it'll just make steam.
Cool little animation.
Yeah. And that's the steam coming out. And then what I wanted to show you is if you take a block, and you right... Or if you shift right-click, it will actually disguise the pipes and everything.
Oh, and the boiler.
Oh, yeah. You can do it for the boiler, too.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. And if you have a wrench in your hand, actually...
Wait, toss me the wrench?
Yeah. Cute. See, we ran out of steam, so it stopped coming out of the top.
When you hold the wrench, it hides the blocks.
Mm-hmm. And if you shift right-click with the wrench, it will just delete the disguise.
Oh, so it'll be like that.
Yeah.
Oh, and if... Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What do you ship it?
No. No.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here's your
wrench. Thank you. Yeah. It has basic stuff.
Will this blow up if we don't pull this off?
Then you can manipulate the pipes with the wrench right here.
Oh, you have to click on the base of it.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I was doing wrong. So that you can, like... Oh, you can rotate this?
Yeah.
So basically, you can, like, if you had machines running over here, and you didn't want them connecting, you could just right-click on it?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So I think we got the basic gist.
Yeah. Okay, so next what we want to go to is, crucibles.
Crucible stage.
Yeah, crucibles. So in here, I guess it's... We got just a bunch of basic stuff.
So, the crucible, which is just some bricks, iron, plate mold. It doesn't show you how to make it.
It's like, watch. Molds.
Oh, just two bricks.
Two bricks to make a blank mold. And you get a mold crafter, which I didn't...
A carving table.
Yeah. It's kind of basic. All you do is put it in the carving table to choose what you want. Yeah. Show you there. Sorry about that.
You kind of skipped over.
Yeah.
So you just place this down. Mm-hmm. Oh, do you just put it on top?
I'm pretty sure. Yeah. No. No, you have a nugget in your hand. That's all. Yeah.
Oh, it rotates through.
It rotates.
I see how it works. Yeah. Okay, okay. So you right click on it, and it will rotate the mold in your hand.
Yeah. Okay, so first off, we're gonna start with a crucible. Just a normal crucible.
Okay, with the mold?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure this is another one. Yeah. Okay, so, crucible.
Yeah.
Why are you choosing wood? That's just gonna catch on fire.
Okay, nice. Yeah. You need a place like this. And then what you can do is put iron in there.
Okay, I just wanna point out, you see these little gray dots on the side? Those are like hinges, so we'll show you what it means.
Yeah, okay.
So you threw iron in there?
Mm-hmm. I just made a little iron.
Can I see some iron?
Yeah.
I don't want to... Toss it to me.
Don't toss too much, because I have to dump it out of here. Actually, I'll just... Okay.
You just toss it in here.
Yeah. Okay. And then what you do is you place a mold. You have to place it this way. As you can... Do you still have that blank... Or that mold?
Yeah.
Go ahead and place that mold inside of it. And it
so
goes
it
like kind that.
Of shapes it, right?
Yeah. And then what you do is shut this.
By right clicking?
Yeah. You have to have it on your hand. You can't have an item in your hand.
Oh, okay.
And then what
Wait,
you do...
Can I click?
Yeah.
Go ahead. So you right click on this and it pours the iron.
Yeah. I like the animation for this.
I'm kind of curious. Can you control this between... with redstone?
Oh, can you?
No, you can't.
No, you can't. Okay. And then go ahead and open this up.
Let me open this.
You get it.
It pops the iron plate in.
I'm gonna go ahead and do it again so it empties out the iron from this. Oh, I just delete it. Okay. So, you mind placing a brick down there? Okay.
So that was one of the ones.
Yeah.
Now here's
so next I want to show off the nether crucible. The nether crucible.
Mm-hmm.
Is basically a crucible that you don't need flames under. Like the other crucible, you needed a heat source under, like flames or lava. This one, you don't need that, so you can just go ahead and toss that straight in there. And I got rid of the mold. And then right here.
I don't want to dump the iron out. Wrong way.
Wrong way, yeah. Did you delete it?
Yeah.
Alright, there we go.
Oh wait, I dumped it when it was open.
It's fine. Just shut it and open it again.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
No?
No. Now it should work.
Yeah. Only takes half
there
an ignot to make one of
ingot.
These. Ones. Ingot. I can never say that. Okay. Ingot. Go ahead and empty this out.
Okay. Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Now we got that part done.
Yeah. So now we need zinc. And where's the copper? It's copper right now. Now I need to empty it. I don't have any free space. Oh, there we go.
Okay.
Let's see. Shit. There we go, and now we made...
Wait, what did you just throw in?
Huh? I threw in one zinc and three copper.
What happens if you throw another zinc in right now?
It will just ruin it and make it all zinc.
And if you throw 3 more copper in, does it double it?
Extra copper? No. If you put 1 zinc and 3 more copper in, then it will.
Okay.
It has to be proportionate. Then you can dump this out.
Looks like sewage. Only if there's a pouring animation.
Yeah. Anyways. And then if you get that, that's how you make brass.
Okay.
Yeah.
You just throw it back in there.
Oh, that's how you make brass. And then if you actually do that with 1 gold ingot, and 3 iron, it will make, what's it called?
Throw it in there.
Throw it in there?
And we'll see what happens.
Okay.
You have it in your inventory.
Yeah.
News.
I know, right?
What? So 1 gold, 3 iron.
Oh, I'm sorry. I messed up. It's a gold, droplet? What are they called?
Nugget.
Yeah, gold nugget. 3 iron and a gold nugget, I believe?
You probably should have looked this up, you idiot.
I did! And let's see. Hold on. I apologize. Crucible. Gilded iron. What you do is... I'm dumb. I'm really dumb. Okay, you just put 1 iron in.
And 1 gold nugget.
Yeah. I already
did it. No, there's still stuff in there.
Yeah, because it just...
It doesn't work there.
Why is it not working? Okay.
Is
oh,
it?
There we go. It works now.
Nope,
you get
just
it?
Normal iron plate.
Hold on. Can we take a break real quick?
No.
No? Okay. Well...
You're stupid. Let me do
yeah.
it.
Yeah. We'll get up in the book.
I did, but...
Yeah.
It's not that difficult.
It is. It doesn't work. I apologize for...
Okay, I don't think it works.
Yeah. I don't think it really works.
Hmm, that's weird.
Okay, yeah.
You're doing it wrong. Where do you craft it? Alright, 1 iron ingot, 1 gold nugget. Should
yeah.
be gold.
You?
Do
you?
I think so. If you do, I feel stupid.
Yeah.
I should have planned this out before.
Should've.
Oh, well.
Oh.
We'll just go with it. No, you don't craft it either.
Yeah. Alright, we're sorry. This doesn't
it's
really work.
It's bugging out or something.
Yeah. Okay, so, we'll just get to the next part. That's crucibles. Messed everything up. You can also make ingots.
Shut up, don't even trust me, just say iron.
Okay, iron molds and the...
Brass.
Alright, and then, here's the fun part. We have some guns and a rocket launcher. I'll let you test those out.
So first, you have to hold it down?
Yeah.
Do you? God, that was loud. Is there a recoil?
No.
And then there's the flintlock musket.
They all take the same ammo except the rocket launcher. And then the
blunderbuss.
That has a recoil.
No, it doesn't.
It did? Oh, it didn't knock you back?
And then this is a normal rocket.
Okay.
I think it's gonna blow up. Hold it.
I would have never guessed.
And...
Alright, don't shoot this. There's a chest. I wanna...
How do you even... Oh, I have an idea.
You need a normal rocket.
It won't change to the collision rocket.
Collision?
Alright. Conclusive.
Oh,
there we go.
Okay. I'm gonna shoot it at the ground close. No. Shoot it at the kill.
I thought it was gonna split up.
Oh,
oh no, it doesn't
blow
break
up.
Once. Oh.
We should have done that one inside.
Oh, I get it. Concussive.
Yeah.
That feels stupid.
Okay. Well,
alright. that's that.
Yeah, okay. So next, these are all the gadgets. You can go ahead and get those.
Oh, there's a lot. Okay, so explain the top hat.
The top hat. The normal top hat you can just wear, it looks stylish.
Aww,
yeah.
Okay.
And then the entrepreneur top hat, which is kind of expensive, actually serves a purpose. Whoa. Yeah, it takes block anyways. When you trade with villagers with that hat on, you get way better deals.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. That's that. And then...
Goggles?
Goggles. Those allow you to zoom in with Z.
Z?
Z.
No, they don't.
Well, those aren't working either. Yeah. But Spyglass, you don't even need to click Z. You just zoom in.
How do you zoom out?
Yeah. But cool. This is mod still pretty new, so it might not work. Now, take the tool, Steam tools you have.
What's a toolkit?
Oh, the toolkit? That just prevents your tools from breaking. Like, if it's at really low health and say you have an enchanted diamond pickaxe, you don't want to lose it. So what it does is it makes sure that tool doesn't break. It won't let you mine after a while.
Okay. If I had a wooden pickaxe and I started digging up and it was at one health, it wouldn't go any further?
Yeah, it wouldn't let you break it with the pick or else the pick would break. So, yeah. And then the pneumatic tools, I just set up a little place to see how fast they have mine.
Can you wear both top hat and mop at the same time?
Yes, but not with your regular inventory.
Okay.
I'll get to that later.
So now I have a saw drill, and shovel. Good.
So just go test
it. I'm pretty sure this...
You're in creative.
I knew that. Okay. I was like, wow, this mine's fast. Yeah. This sucks.
They are kind of. Yeah, they're pretty slow, but...
Oh, wait.
Oh, you didn't turn it on, did you?
So you hold it down?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
So it's not that bad.
No, it's not.
Come on, shovel.
Shovel?
Sure.
Oh, there you go. That goes a little faster. Okay.
And so then, you hold down right click to turn it on, or charge it up.
Yeah.
And it's taking steam, I'm guessing.
It takes...
So what does this item canister
do? This item canister does... go ahead, take that shovel and canister and put them both in your inventory. Or your crafting bench. Yeah.
Okay.
Now you can see it's canistered. So if you... something came and blew you up.
Oh. Toss it back in the room.
Yeah. Something came and blew you up and you're all dead. Do I have, magnet mode? I do. I don't know why I have magnet mode. Okay. But yeah. Say it's on the ground like that. Mm-hmm. It won't despawn.
It won't despawn. It
won't despawn. So if you die in survival, and you don't want, your diamonds to get lost...
Just canister?
Yeah.
Canister. Now, can you canister, a stack? Or does it...
I think it only does one, but...
Where's the canister at?
Right there. I think it only does one, but there's, ways to make it so it's more effective.
Are you sure?
Future stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Show you that later on.
Run away, and then we'll come back in a little bit and show you. This will be gone, but these will stay.
Yeah.
Okay, so now that... Oh, by the way, don't mind this stack of
ores
just yet. That's later in the video.
Okay. So I'm going to be showing you how you can use all this stuff and a little bit extra in one big build. Mm-hmm. You kind of have a lot of stuff in here, so...
Oh, there's a steam tank. Yeah. You never showed on the valve pipe, but it's a lever.
Yeah,
and I'm a pipe. Okay. Yeah. Fan flash boiler component. Kind of expensive.
Yeah.
Archimedes screw.
Mm-hmm.
Gauge. Steam whistle. Rupture disc.
Yeah.
And that's okay. Okay, so.
So where should I go set this up? Right here?
Okay.
I'll just set it up here. Okay, so. These are called flash boilers, and what you do is make a 2x2x2.
Whoops. 2x2x2?
Yeah.
Okay.
I used the wrong thing. Okay, this is a flash boiler. And on this side, you can see the face. It's a big boiler, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. And
can you disguise this?
What?
Can you disguise this?
Disguise it? No, unfortunately, no. You might be able to in a later version, but
Okay.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up an infinite source of water right here. For, let's see. Oops.
I'm going to set it up here.
the Archimedes screw. Right here. Yep. I forgot. Like this.
Okay.
And then take a bucket. This, and that creates an infinite water source.
Mm-hmm.
And then what we're gonna need is some pipes to power this Archimedes screw. This basically just collects water and pits it in the machine for you, or places. Yeah. They're not. Oh yeah. There. Okay. See the.
And so comes in here. What is this doing?
Okay. So now if you see, I come in here.
Mm-hmm.
I put that, and I have a little bit of water to get it started. You can see the Archimedes cube is getting water.
So it's collecting water from the source behind it.
Yeah.
And putting it in here?
Uh-huh.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Uh-huh. And then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make a little safety feature. Yeah, just collect this stuff.
Aren't you just losing all your steam?
Yeah. Well, that's why I have a valve.
Okay, so this valve, you right-click.
Yeah.
With a bare hand, and it will open and close it?
Yeah.
Okay, that's
I'm
cool.
Gonna keep that closed for now.
The steam hurt.
I'm gonna add a rupture disc right here. And a rupture disc is if you think your thing's gonna explode,
mm-hmm.
you might want to put a rupture disc, and what happens is if it's about to explode, it'll just rupture,
yeah.
and the steam will just get let out to release all the pressure. Should probably put one over here, too. And then, that's just a safety feature. Then another one is a steam whistle. And that's for, before the rupture disc even goes off, it'll start whistling.
Mm-hmm.
Which will signify that steam's building up pretty quickly. You might want to let some go.
Yeah. Which one you just do this.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then another thing I want to place is a steam gauge. Over here, and that will just show you how much steam buildup there is in there.
Oh, almost a half.
Yeah, it's just this one little pipe. So this is just a bunch of safety devices I placed. And then what I want to do with this stuff is let's see, what else? All right, I just need this. And what I'm gonna set up over here, I'm adding a steam tank, which is basically storage for steam.
Okay.
Pretty self-explanatory right there.
So that's a tank?
Yeah, this is a tank. You can't really click on it, but you can put gauges on the tanks.
In on any side?
Any side, yeah.
Okay, can you put rupture
disc? Actually, not the top, and the bottom.
Okay.
I believe so. And I know you can put whistles on them. Yeah, you can put a rupture disc on it.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. And then I'm going to add a fan right here, and fans are pretty cool, actually.
Oh, nope, you can't use non-solid blocks to disguise.
Yeah.
Oh, and another feature, I'm just messing around, if you take glowstone and you try to disguise something, it actually doesn't give off light. It's hard to tell if it's glowstone, but it doesn't give off light. Just a fun fact.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what's this thing you have right here?
That's a fan. Okay. It will basically just push items and people.
And entities, basically.
Yeah. All that stuff. Now, you could go ahead and disguise this if you really wanted to, but it's all good. then what I need to do...
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's the whistle. So I'm going to let off some steam. And that actually starts up this. Before we go on it, I'm going to... If you shift right-click, it will change the range with the wrench.
Oh, with the wrench?
Yeah.
So, 13, 15, 17... Is it? Oh.
You might want to go to 11 right now.
11?
Yep.
Alright.
Okay. And then once we have that,
mm-hmm.
You can float. And then if you shift, you go down.
So I'm flying. Yeah. Trap door.
Flying up.
And shift to go down?
Yeah.
So like if you're flying.
Mm-hmm.
If I can shift.
Yeah.
Touching a block.
There you go.
There we go.
Alright. Yeah. That's... So you can just use them as elevators, too. Oh. Hit Q on it, though? Or pin a block inside of it? Like,
Drop a
throw a few blocks, yeah. It'll make the blocks float.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Okay, so next I want to do you still have those tools?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So go ahead and put those in these.
In what, this?
Yeah.
What is this?
This is a filler, and it will fill up your tools with steam. If you notice, they lost some power. No, it's already filled up because we didn't use them that much.
You just right-click on it and place it down, fills it up.
Uh-huh. We'll get to this later. But yeah.
Okay. That's so you're saying we'll get to this block and that stuff a little later.
Yeah. We'll go back to that.
Okay, so let's get over here.
Okay. So first, what I want to show you is come
all the way
up
down.
Here. Oh, yeah. We're going up here. Okay. So I have an iron sword. If you go ahead and get that in the chest. Oh, yeah. And I want to explain. These, like, purple blocks right here, those are actually just creative steam blocks.
The infinite steam.
Yeah, they're infinite. You can only get them in creative. I just,
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And then go ahead and click on the hammer, not the anvil.
What is this?
This is a steam hammer.
Okay.
And basically it's an anvil, but you don't need experience for it.
So go ahead and the whistle's going off again.
Yeah.
So,
let me go ahead and read that. That's the rupture disc.
That's the other rupture disc.
Yeah.
So, there's actually a waiting pool. What is going on? Oh, I might as well show you the animation. That is awesome. Alright, you guys see our airbase from the last episode over there. It looks terrible without any of the planes or anything.
Just making some of the noises and stuff. Okay.
So now I renamed it.
Yeah. So that's the sword. What'd you name the sword?
A JD sword.
Oh. That's that. You can just enchant. Or not enchant. Yeah.
Repair.
Yeah. Name. And it does actually damage the anvil.
Oh, it does.
Yeah. You need the anvil down here. It's not just decoration.
Okay. Unlike these.
Yeah. Okay.
Funny story. Yeah. Anyways. Okay. What's this?
So next thing is the rock crusher.
Okay.
Let me get a wrench real quick. 64 wrenches will be. Okay. So if you get this iron in the chest. Oh, there's a wrench in there.
I'll take the wrench.
Yeah. Okay. So just go ahead and place a block right there.
This? Iron ore?
Uh-huh. Crushes it. And you get these out of it.
Which is smashed
iron.
Okay.
Well. And you can actually smelt that down, and you get two.
Oh, so it basically doubles your ore output.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then if you want to, you can go to block breaker. Go ahead and place that.
So it just breaks blocks.
Yes, it breaks blocks.
So you can make an infinite cobblestone generator out of this.
Yeah, you can even make like obsidian. If you don't want to mine up the obsidian, you can just place it there and place lava and
water. It does break obsidian, though, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
It does not.
It doesn't? What? That's kind of cheap.
Okay.
Oh, sorry about that. Okay, so now, what I want to get to is this thing. Now, I'm hoping this will work with the blocks above it. It should, though. Okay, so in here I have a strobel.
Okay, just some brass and redstone.
I'm gonna go ahead and take this. This should work, yeah. I'm gonna go fly out over here. And I'm gonna shift right click. Sure. And then if you actually go on the strobel in your inventory, there will actually be the coordinates on it.
Toss it in?
Okay.
No.
Yeah.
Okay, in the overworld.
Uh-huh.
So then you come back up here.
Fly back up here. And then there's some stuff. Okay, I took it?
No, I took it.
Okay. Just put that stuff in the hopper. Did you?
There was nothing on there. Just put it in there. Whoops.
Just place stuff in the hopper then. Now you can get in the hopper.
And then you shift click on this?
You just click with it.
Oh. Normal. Oh, normal? No, that'd break it.
Hmm? No, you already did it.
Alright. Now why isn't it working?
Break block.
I did.
Okay, it's not working because there's blocks above it.
You break the blocks.
Yeah. Not sure if it has to be directly above it or on. Okay. Let's see if.
Told you. Oh God. Oh,
there we go. Yeah.
I'll move out of the way.
And it just launches the block up. If you go down to this obsidian.
So this is where we marked it, right?
Yeah. It should come down eventually.
Takes a while.
Takes a while.
We had to split our blimp up. I'll fix that later. Are you sure they're coming down?
They take a long time.
I don't see anything up here.
Yeah, it took a while.
Whoa, they're gonna go over here.
Over here.
So that's a little buggy.
Yeah.
Well, that's cool. It has
bombs.
So is this like a canister? Will these ever despawn?
I don't think so. They're just canisters.
They're falling back on top of it.
They are.
Yeah.
Yeah. These do have a lot of range though, so.
Okay. We were pretty close. It's a little bit buggy.
It's a little bit, yeah. Okay. So the next thing I want to show you is the fan. Fan was earlier. So I got some spruce wood, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can also go on it and it'll
suck you?
Yeah. It'll suck you.
Damage you?
Hmm? No, it doesn't damage you. That'd be awesome.
Oh, you can make like a mob grinder if it did. No, just put a cactus there or something.
Now I'm gonna be keep an eye or watch.
So this is 8 blocks long.
Yeah. Let's throw some wood.
Yeah, it has to be like along the scope.
You can just throw wood blocks in here. And then it'll go back in the chest.
So it's a hopper that sucks.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, so you could actually use this in a mob grinder.
But then, can you hook this up to a mortar so then like...
Yeah, you could.
That's awesome.
I do a little mortar because it's annoying. It's okay.
A little buggy too.
Yeah. All right. Should we do the thumper?
Let's do the thumper. It's a little bit weird.
Yeah.
It doesn't quite work the way we plan.
Okay. This is the reason we put all those blocks down there.
Yeah, so basically, it's...
Yeah.
Basically a mining well kind of thing. So you just want to turn it on and... You see if it works?
I don't want to, but I kind of have to.
I like the animation.
Yeah, I do.
It reminds me of those carnival rides that drop you.
Yeah.
So we can actually turn it off. There's tons of steam. Okay. If we come down here...
Oh,
it blew up.
Yeah, it blew up.
So it's actually breaking these blocks, but not sucking them in.
Yeah.
So you just have to let it run for a little bit, and then come down here and collect everything.
Yeah. Now the book, see he's breaking the steps too.
We're gonna
go ahead and delete that.
Okay, yeah. So that's how it works. Yeah. It basically mines everything below it.
Okay. So that's that. And the mod, or not the mod, the book actually did say that there will eventually be something that you can attach to it that will make it so you collect the blocks.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, okay. So now I get to my favorite part, which is the exoskeleton.
I just did it. Alright, Whoa.
Yeah, I have a lot of stuff set up here. So, first thing, I'm gonna get the chest plate.
Wait, don't take it out. Put it back in. Bro.
Okay. Just get all the...
This takes a little bit.
Yeah.
And then the exo headpiece?
Yes.
So, that. Power fist.
No, I want to do all of them.
Brass knuckles. Steam exo legs. Yeah, leg piece. Yeah. And then foot piece.
Yeah. Okay. And then, so what I want to show you first.
Alright.
Is the steam exoskeleton. I'm going to just do this for simplicity.
Alright, so he's going to wear it just so we can... You look ridiculous with that.
I know. There's upgrades.
You look like a monkey.
This is like very busy. I know. Alright, now I do walk really slow because... There's nothing attached to it yet.
It's heavy.
Yeah. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna attach a heavy reinforcement, which I have in my hand right now.
Is that the gold plating?
No, this is a tank. This is an exosuit tank. And then, can you actually come in this engineer table with me?
Yeah.
And then, I don't see any of this stuff. Okay.
There, toss it to me then.
Yeah? Okay. Go ahead and put all this stuff on. Okay, then. You want to get...
It doesn't... Yeah, you do walk a lot slower.
Yeah, alright, so get in this engineer chest.
Alright.
Now click on the chest piece.
Chest?
And put it in that slot right there. Okay. And you'll see that. Mm-hmm. You can go ahead and put this heavy reinforcement in the
this
box.
One?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
And then you'll see you have a little bar right there. So go ahead and put that back on. And then, now I'm going to go to F5 for this because it looks awesome. Yeah, F5. Like that. Now just go ahead and step on this thing. Yeah.
Okay.
If you can get on this.
This is a little different.
A little sucky, man. See that?
And what's it doing?
It's charging up your thing. Your...
How long does this take?
Whoa. Huh? Not that long. You don't need it that charge. The charge lasts a long time.
Barely doing anything.
Yeah. Because I have the best tank you can get. There's a few different tanks you can use, and this is, like, the highest of the upgrades.
Okay, well, we're at 80,000... Steam units, I believe that's what SU stands for.
That should actually be good for now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Alright, you just walk off.
Yeah. No, you walk normally.
Yeah.
Okay, so next I want you to get all these gold exoskeleton plates.
Exosuit plates.
Exosuit plates. Okay. Go ahead, go in there.
Mm-hmm. And drag each piece.
Yep. Yeah. And now you won't look that derpy.
That derpy? So you're saying you look a little derpy.
Only a little.
Still, it doesn't quite match my face. But I like the armor a lot better.
Yeah. But we still have a little upgrade. Yeah. Go ahead and get this lapis. You can do this with any dye, actually. I just chose lapis.
Just chose lapis for simplicity?
Yeah.
And that's how you put it in the paintbrush spot.
Yep.
Can you do multiple colors?
Yeah, you can do multiple. Not on one piece, but...
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright.
Well, alright, that looks a lot cooler.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my eyes are covered up. I can't see out of this thing.
Yeah. Okay, so, next thing.
Alright.
I want you to get the top hat and the monocle.
Alright.
Okay.
Go back in here.
Yes.
Put that in. Mm-hmm. I take it, I put it on here and there.
Yeah. And that's how you're gonna... attach both of them. Now you don't actually see the top hat, which kind of sucks, but you can see the monocle.
What if you do the... Oh, no, you can't. Never.
One thing the mod creators haven't, like, I wish they do is multiplayer. I don't see any of the upgrades.
Oh, you don't see...
No. I just see it as a normal exoskeleton.
Okay, exosuit.
Yeah. Okay, so next, I want to...
Extendo fist.
Get all four of these, actually.
Okay.
Now, go in here, and then choose which one you want.
Let's see, which one looks cool? Extendo fist.
Extendo fist.
Oh, you put it in here? What goes in here?
What goes in there? Either steam wings or a jetpack.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now that I have this on, what does extendo fist do?
I don't know, I haven't tested that one. Oh, you can reach far.
Oh, yeah. Holy crap.
Cool.
How far can he reach?
Mm-hmm.
Can I come stand back here?
That far.
Oh, dude, I can reach a mile away. I can reach all the way over there.
I can reach right here.
That's extended fist.
And then, go in your inventory. Power fist just gives a, like, a little punch. I'm pretty sure it does punch. Yeah. Okay. You can go ahead.
Oh, God, wait. God. That didn't hurt you, though.
Oh, God. It makes a big explosion, though.
Are you in survival?
Yeah.
Huh.
Doesn't do too much damage. It did a little bit. Alright. Okay, but go ahead and attach the...
Did it crash?
Nope. No. This is lag. Go ahead and attach the brass knuckles. I like these. Okay. Put that on. I might want to go outside for this.
Uh-oh.
Does it work on adventure? I don't need these. Okay.
Oh!
That's why I like these.
Home run.
It's out of here. Okay. Go back.
Dude, wait, I want to see how far I can hit you. Come stand over here. Come stand on this, like, intersection.
Okay. Can you hit me while I'm in creative?
No.
Okay.
Now come stand on this little X.
Oh, this stopped me. No, don't push me!
Yes!
I'm in creative.
It's okay. Iron Man. Alright. Anyways, continuing.
Yeah. Okay.
You got a little sidetracked.
So, go ahead and put that last one on.
The hitting. Oh.
Alright, now put that on.
Sorry.
You're having a little bit of trouble. Okay. And go ahead, get on a wall, and just hold space. And go up. Okay, let me. I think it's good.
Is it on the power? I saw it worked earlier.
Yeah. This mod does have a lot of glitches.
Yeah, let me look this up. What was it called? Hidden?
What? Try wool. Maybe it can't be wood. Because I did it on wool earlier. I don't know. Let me try.
Hold on. No, you don't get a try.
Alright. It's under exercise.
Yeah, just exosuit? Right,
so arms.
Where's the arms?
Okay. Go.
Let's see. There's a little... Oh, right clicking.
Oh, okay. Hold down right click in space. You can go forward.
Oh, well, it was kind of working.
Hold down right click and just go forwards. Hold everything down.
I am.
Really? It's not working?
Not really.
Huh. Okay. Well, that's that. That usually works. Maybe it's not working. It's crying in so much time. Okay.
Hold on. Yeah. I want to see why it's not working. It's pretty cool, you guys.
Yeah.
Last minute. My right clicking.
Okay. Very nice space. Hold down right there. Yeah. Just forwards.
I can climb down it.
You can hang on. Well.
Oh, I bet you it's because you had your jetpack on.
Oh yeah, probably. Okay. Well, that brings us to the next thing.
I'll save you on.
Jetpacks.
Steam wings?
Steam wings and jetpacks.
Okay.
You can try on.
First. Let's do jetpack.
Yeah.
I think you just...
Yeah. Just like any other jetpack.
You do take full damage.
Only right? A little bit. Okay, now I want to get the steam wings for this next one.
I can't sprint jump. Right, while you're cleaning that up, I'm just going to switch this out.
Yeah.
So you put the steam wings in
okay.
here. And I take it you glide with these?
Yeah. I haven't tried these yet. Yeah. Gliding.
Oh, that's cool.
Hit F5, it looks pretty cool.
Oh, it does. Oh, and it has the steam gauge on it.
Yeah.
Dude, I look like Birdman.
That's not from the wings, that's just the suit.
Yeah, yeah. But you can't... Oh, it folds up.
Yeah.
But you can't fly with these.
Nah. I wish you could attach a jetpack and the wings.
That'd be OP. Okay.
Okay. So, just that how you want.
Alright.
And then, what are we on now?
Thrusters.
Thrusters. And cameras. Thrusters.
Alright. Leg piece or feet?
No? Huh? Leg.
Acoustic.
That goes on the leg.
And then the canner?
What that does is, when, I think you need cans in your, inventory, but whenever you pick a block, it automatically cans it. Like, pick up a block there. I'll touch it there. Now, are they all canned? No.
I think it has to be a gem.
And does it? don't know. But they automatically can the items.
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah.
There has to be value.
Okay. But so that cans all your items for you.
And the damper? I'm pretty sure it just dampens fall damage. Oh, it automatically rejects my wing suit.
Yeah.
Okay, so it just reduces fall damage.
Yeah.
Self-explanatory. Mm-hmm. And then, change you with thrusters?
Yeah.
Oh no, that goes on your feet.
Yeah. Okay, so this basically...
No, it doesn't go on either of them.
It might go on actual feet.
Oh, I see.
Or legs. No, legs. Did you try legs?
Yeah, I tried legs.
Oh.
Of course I tried legs.
Oh, yeah. It says it's under hips.
Oh, there we go.
Oh.
They just made it weird.
Okay. So, yeah. That basically just lets you move faster when flying.
Oh, yeah. Dude, I'm flying down this thing.
Yeah. Yeah, it goes faster like that. Okay. And if you have a jetpack on, you fly faster.
Awesome.
Yeah, I guess.
And then fall assist, lead actuator, and pulse mode.
Yeah. Where you forgot the modular accelerator.
Where does that go?
It makes you go faster.
Oh.
It's on legs.
It doesn't matter. It makes you move faster.
It's pretty simple.
So pulse nozzle and lead
actuator.
So what does the pulse nozzle do?
Let's see. Oh, wait, no, it's full center. Oh, it's just a double jump, pretty much.
Double jump?
It makes you jump high.
Yeah. I thought that was the leap.
It's both of them combined that's making you jump so
high. Oh, yeah, you can double jump.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Okay, so... Is that it? Oh no, you have
fall
damage.
Pretty self-explanatory. Yeah.
Take no fall damage.
None?
Yeah. Or I don't know if it's none. No, that's where the pulse jet is.
Just out of curiosity, let me take this off.
Yeah.
Let's see how well this works. And actually, this is the end of our
video right
spotlight.
Here. So?
Oh yeah, really reduced it.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh yeah. You're gonna have to fix that so you don't take the fall damage when you double jump.
You're not actually taking damage.
I know, but it's just the animation.
Can you jump over this gate?
Anyways.
Yeah.
So that wraps up our Flaxbeard's steam-powered mod.
Highly recommend it.
Yeah, really awesome. Oh, also it does the one block assist. You don't need a jump.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's another cool thing. Anyways, so we'll see you guys next time. Peace!